What about all these other parts of the eye? What do they do?
Well, there's a lot going on here, so let's talk about it. Right here, we have this clear protective membrane, and that's called the cornea. And the eye's pretty important, so its job is basically just to protect everything that's going on inside.
And how about the blue part here?
Well, that's the colored part of our eye. That's called the iris. And in addition to being very pretty, it's a muscle that constricts or dilates to change the amount of light that's let in through this guy here, and that's called the pupil. And when it's dim, you'll notice that your pupils tend to be pretty big, versus when it's bright out, they tend to be pretty small, because they don't need as much light.
And then what about this guy right here?
Right, that's the lens. Remember how before we were talking about how the light gets bent when it enters the eye?
Uh-huh.
Well, the lens is what does that bending, that focusing, to make sure that the light enters and is focused onto the back of the retina.
And when it hits the retina, that's where our rods and cones are, right?
Yeah, exactly. Those rods and cones are called photoreceptor cells. And so this retina actually contains many layers of these rods and cones. And so rods, photoreceptor cells, photo means light, receptor means to receive, they actually are sensitive to primarily black and white vision, and they help us see at nighttime.
So then, does that mean the cones help us see color?
Exactly. And there's actually three different types of cones. Some are sensitive to red light, which is a long wavelength. Some are sensitive to green or medium wavelength light. And some are sensitive to blue short wavelength light. So these are used for color vision.